Hey everyone! Today I'm going to be walking you through the process of creating a speed boost pickup in Roblox Studio. Now first things first, as always, is to open up a new Roblox Studio project or one you've already been working on. And then the next thing we're going to do is create a part. And what I always like to do is I always like to make it just a little bit bigger. So I'm going to grab my scale tool and I'll scale it a little bit. There we go. We're going to make this one really big. And I'm also going to make it in the air a little bit and anchor it. And I'm going to make it just like this first one you saw at the beginning of the video. So I'm going to change this brick color to green to show that it is a speed boost. And also in the properties panel on the right side, we are going to turn off can collide but leave on can touch. All right. So now the next step is to create a script on this part. Create the script and it'll open it up and we can delete the line that Roblox Studio leaves for us. Now the first thing we have to make, as usual for all scripts, is the variables we're going to need later on in the code. So the first variable we're going to need is local player equals game colon get service players. And we're going to be using the player service later in the game to just verify the whatever touched the block is a player in the game and not like an AI, like a zombie or something. And then we're going to need a reference to the actual part. So let's call this speed boost equals script dot parent. And then we're going to create another variable called local. We'll call this one speed value. And this one is going to be the value of how fast we want the player to run after they pick up the object or the pickup. And the default walk speed in Roblox is 16. I'm not sure what units it is, but 16 is the amount. So why don't for right now we double that? We're going to go 32. And then two more variables. We're going to need a local respawn time. And this is equal to how long we want the pickup effect to last. So how long we want the speed boost effect to last. So now let's set this to, for now, let's set this to 10. I have it for 6 seconds set in the introductory video, but let's set it to 10 for now. And then one more variable, we're going to call this collected equals false. And this will tell us if the item has been picked up or not. And is the effect still being applied to some character in the game world. And now let's create our function. So as always, start with local and then we'll type function. And we'll call this one onTouch, since that's when we will be calling it. And it's going to have a parameter of other part, which is going to be the part that touches it. Hit enter, we get the end automatically. And now we're going to need an if statement. And this if statement is going to check whether the object has been collected or not. So if the object isn't collected, we want to run the code. So if collected equals equals false, there we go. Then what do we want to do? First we want to set collected to true. So if collected is false, we want to start the code. So now the object is collected, let's set that equal to true. And now we're going to need a couple variables inside this function. The first one is going to be the character attached to the part that touched it. Let's call this, just call it for short, char equals other part dot parent. And then we're going to need another one that is going to find a part on the character that is the humanoid part. The humanoid part in Roblox is the part that keeps track of a character's health, speed, and a couple other basic variables and needed functions. So let's call this human equals char colon, since we're calling a function, find first child, which is a parentheses humanoid. And then we need one more variable, which let's call this player. And this is where we're going to use our player variable that we initialized before, colon. Let's actually call, let me rename this players variable at the beginning to just players. And then I'll rename it here. So now, on this, we want to call the function get player from character. Character. And inside the parentheses, we're going to put our character. So I called that char. So now, what this function is doing, it's not doing a lot so far. If it hasn't been collected, it's going to set the pickup to collected. And then it's going to set three variables. The first one is getting the parent of the part that touched it. And then it's checking to see if there's a human item attached to that character. And then it's asking the player service if this character is a player. And now we have to check if this is a player. So if player, and if human.walkSpeed equals 16, then. So now we want to check if the thing that touched the object is a player, and if its walk speed is the default walk speed, which is 16, as I explained earlier. And if those two are true, so if it is a player and it has the default walk speed, and since it's inside the if collected equals false statement, so it has to meet three conditions in order to get to this part. It has to not be collected, the item has to not be collected, the part that touched it has to be a player, and the player has to have the default walk speed. Now, we're going to set humanoid. So if all those are true, we're going to do humanoid.walkSpeed equals speed value. And then we're going to, so that will now set the player's speed, the player who touched it, to our double speed. And now we want to disable the part for a bit. So we want it to make disappear. So we want to touch it and then we want it to disappear. Speed, and we referenced our part as speed boost dot transparency equals 1. Not 2. Transparency goes from 0 to 1, 0 being fully visible, 1 being fully invisible. And then once those are set, we want to wait for our respawn time. And then a couple more things. After we wait, we want to set the human's walk speed back to the original walk speed equals 16. And then we also want to set the speed boost object to be visible. So we need to set the speed boost the speed boost dot transparency equals 0. And then after this end, for the if player and human.walkSpeed equals 16, we're going to do one more thing. We're going to set the collectible. We're going to set collected to equal false. So what this will do, as soon as something touches the part, it's going to check if the part, if this speed pickup has been collected yet. And if it has, it's just going to end the function, not going to do anything else. If it hasn't, it's going to say, hey, I've been collected, or at least somebody's attempting to collect me. And then it's going to create a couple variables. And then with those variables, it's just going to check if what touched it is a player. And if it is a player, it just one checks. It's going to check if its walk speed is the default walk speed. And if that's not true, it's just going to end and do nothing, basically. But if it is true, we're going to set the walk speed to the speed boost walk speed that we want, which we set to 32. Make the speed boost invisible for a little bit. Wait for 10 seconds, since that's what I set my respawn time to. And then, after 10 seconds, we're going to reset the human walk speed back to the normal. And we're going to make our speed boost visible again. And then we're going to set collected to false, just so then somebody can pick up the object again. And now one last thing we have to do in this script is attach it to our part. So let's type speed boost dot touched colon connect on touch. And there we go. So now let me test my script really quick. I'll delete my old speed block. And now let's test the script out. I'm going to hit F5 to start our game. And after we wait for it to load up, there's my speed boost block. Now let me touch it. And I have a speed boost. And as you can see, it disappears. And now let me wait for a little bit just to show you that it wears off. And there we go. So as soon as it wears off, the speed block comes back into view. And it's as easy as that. If you followed along, you should have a working speed block, a working speed pickup now in your Roblox game. And this is a great thing to use for obbies if you want to make it a little challenge for the obbies. Try to see if they can get through there faster. It can also be used for team fight games. Have a speed boost pickup. They can run around faster so they can get to the enemies faster. Has a lot of uses in a lot of different games. So I hope you guys found this useful, and if there's any questions, leave them down below. Make sure to like and subscribe if you learned anything from this, and I hope to see you guys next time. Bye!